This is beauty. It helps me at times reconnect with God. In fact, Wendell Berry says the Bible is an outdoor book. It's best read and understood in the outdoors, and further outdoors, the better. I love that. And I suspect that there are many of us here today that that's probably true. We live in an area that it's very easy to go outdoors and enjoy the beauty of God's creation, and in a sense, reconnect with God at the same time. I think the author of Psalms 8 had that same experience. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars that you have established, what are human beings that you are mindful of them, mortals that you care for them. And the modern book, Traveling Verses, tells a wonderful story of seeing God's beauty in another. It seems that she started attending a church. If you know and ever read any of her books, she had a real struggle of faith. Sadly, she was here in town just a couple of months ago, and I didn't get a chance to hear her, but in her book, Traveling Mercy, she kind of shares her journey of faith. And she began to attend a church, and that church was a pretty open congregation. And one Sunday, this man named Ken came into church, and he sort of sat by himself. But about two weeks after he came, he shared during a prayer time that his partner had died of AIDS. As Kim continued to come to church, Miss Lamont noticed a woman in the choir named Renola. She was beautiful and jovial and black. She was as devout as she could be, but she was a little standoffish toward Kim. She always looked at him with confusion. Or she would look at him from the corner of her eyes when she did look at him. You see, she had been raised as a Southern Baptist and was struggling with that history in relationship to Ken. But over time, Ken won over even the diehards of the congregation who were afraid of getting the disease. Now you have to understand, this book was published in the 1990s. Ken finally missed several studies because of his illness. When he came back, he was very thin and could not even stand for the singing of the hymns, even with a face that was distorted by his illness during the prayer time. He would talk joyously of his decline, of grace, and how safe and happy he felt those days. And as he began to sing the hymn that particular Sunday for which Ken could not stand, Winola watched Ken rather skeptically for a moment, and then her face began to melt. And it contorted just like her at his. She went to his side, bent down to lift him up, lifted up this white rag doll, this scarecrow. She held him next to her, draped over against her like a child, while they sang. God looked back at all that God had created and called it good and beautiful. Let us not forget that we are beautiful in the eyes of God. That the person who has hate in their heart and in their eyes is also beautiful in the sight of God. 40 years ago, Bill Staines wrote a great song. I think we've actually sung it here on Sunday morning. It's called A Place in the Choir. The chorus goes like this: all God's critters got a place in the choir. Some sing low, some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or pause. Or anything they got now. We are part of that choir that needs to sing of the beauty and goodness of all that God has created and continues to create.